The biggest news that came out of the auto industry last week is that Xiaomi, the phone manufacturer, debuted the first vehicle, the SU7. Now, first thing first, let's get the obvious out of the way. Yes, it probably have taken a few design inspirations from the Porsche Taycan. There is a rumor that the CEO of Xiaomi, Mr. Lei Jun, who presented the vehicle yesterday, the man himself owns a Taycan. So I'll let you dwell on that. And the similarity between the two vehicles extend beyond the way they look. Dimensionally speaking, the two vehicles are nearly identical. But if we look past beyond the design similarities, the two vehicles are obviously very different, not least because of their price point. The base trim of the Xiaomi starts at 216,000 CNY, that's roughly about $30,000. The standard version have a 73.6 kWh of lithium-ion phosphate battery made by BYD. Xiaomi claims a CLTC range of 700 kilometers. If it seems to be unrealistically high, it is. I've just made a video explaining the CLTC range. Check it out if you want to know more about it. Anyway, it should be able to provide just shy of 500 kilometers of real-world range in temperate climate. It is powered by a 299 horsepower permanent magnet electric motor mounted on the rear axle. It should be able to do 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in just 5.7 seconds. For that MSRP, you would expect this trim to be pretty frugal, but it's actually very well equipped. Amongst the standard equipment, you get a leather-wrapped heated steering wheel, a dual-zone automatic climate control with heat pump, a 12-way adjustable heated and ventilated front driver's seat. The front passenger seat have everything else except for the 4-way lumbar support. The second row is also heated. You got wireless phone charging. It even have wireless CarPlay, which is something I did not expect, and frankly, not very common in China. You also get a 10-speaker audio system, panoramic glass roof, keyless entry, 19-inch alloys wrapped in 245 tires, matrix LED headlights, 360-degree camera, and a suite of sensors capable of L2 autonomous driving. That's a lot of equipment. But if the base trim is insufficient, then you may step up to the Pro trim, which starts at 246,000 CNY. That's roughly about $34,000. It receives a larger 94.3 kWh of LFP battery manufactured by CATL this time. It's still rear-wheel drive with the same 299 horsepower motor, but the larger battery pack bumps the nominal range to 830 kilometers. Apart from the larger battery, it also have a more sophisticated autonomous driving system with navigate on autopilot ability on pre-mapped street. This is a hands-off-the-wheel system enabled by an additional LiDAR sensor. Pro model can also option an active aero and electronically deploy spoiler, although I imagine it's not for downforce, mostly for vanity's sake. The Max trim is the ultimate and the performance-oriented top trim of the SU7, which starts at 299,000 CNY, or about $41,000. It has a larger 101 kWh, but this time a lithium-ion battery from the CATL. It's also all-wheel drive, by adding an asynchronous electric motor to the front axle, but also using a different and more powerful permanent magnet motor on the rear axle. Together, they produce 673 horsepower, able to propel this vehicle to 100 kilometers per hour in just 2.8 seconds. However, this does make the vehicle consume more energy. So despite the larger battery pack, the claimed range dropped to 800 kilometers. But the aforementioned battery pack, by being lithium-ion, does allow the vehicle to charge quicker. We don't know exactly how many kilowatt it can take on, but at DC charge stations, it should be able to charge 50% quicker than the base model. In keeping with the performance inclinations, this model also comes with a standard adaptive air suspension with adjustable dampers. This will probably be necessary if you choose the option, the 21-inch alloys, which give you the wider 265 Pirelli tires in the back. This model also comes fully loaded in terms of creature comfort, including soft-closed doors, heads-up display, a better sound system, and even active side lumbar. Now, personally, I believe the base trim and the max trim represents the best value in the lineup. You can also option in the 25-speaker sound system in the lower two trims in case you need them. But during the spec reading, I found something quite interesting, is that the SU7, compared to its closest competition in the segment, that would be the Zeekr 007. That vehicle almost seems to be designed to combat the Xiaomi, even though it was released a couple months ago. They are similar even in terms of namesake. But the Xiaomi SU7, while being a physically larger car, is quite a bit lighter, indicating a more aluminum-intensive construction. So Xiaomi really is putting out its best foot forward with this vehicle. They're really sparing no expense in the R&D. But it's not quite an outlier, as some people would hope it would to be. It doesn't really bring anything to the table that the other manufacturers haven't in this particular segment. And the competition is intensive, to say the least. I guess only time will tell if Xiaomi will be able to come out ahead. But my gut feeling tells me that even though this vehicle is a fantastic value, that alone is simply not enough anymore. And truthfully, Xiaomi is likely not making that much money, or more likely case, they're losing money on every vehicle they sold. Which only begs the question, why release a not very differentiated model into an already very crowded market, with a vehicle with fantastic engineering, but wearing some other company's design? Now, obviously, Xiaomi is not the only company guilty of this issue. But if my money were on the line, I would say they are turning this platform into an SUV. So let's see if Xiaomi is able to redeem themselves with a more original design for that model. I will see you then.